Hello, everyone. My name is Jin Zhang. I'm the product director for RISC Formal at Synopsys. Today, I'm speaking with Shaun Feng. Shaun is a senior principal engineer at SiFive, responsible for RISC-V formal verification. Prior to that, Shaun led CPU, GPU, system IP formal verification at many companies, including Samsung, NVIDIA, Freescale, AMD. Shaun is one of the major industry contributors using formal sequential request checking technology for clock gating sign-off. Shaun got his PhD in formal verification from the University of British Columbia, Vancouver, Canada. He has 6 patents and over 30 technical publications. Welcome, Shaun.
Thank you, Jane, for having me.
Yeah, so my first question to you is related to clock gating sign-off. Can you explain to our audience here what it is and why is that important?
Clock gating is a critical low-power design methodology. We want to turn off the toggling of a clock on the flops when the contribution of the flop will not be propagated to the output. And when we need it, we wake up the clock, then the circuitry can start compute. And by turning on off the clock, we save lots of dynamic power. Based on our experience, up to 50% of dynamic power can be saved using clock gating. So now we have a very interesting verification problem. With without clock gating, do we have functional equivalency? In the past, we rely on verification. We run simulation. But it is extremely difficult for a simulation, either direct simulation or constrained random simulation, to hit the clock gating bug. Because you gotta need to craft a very special case to expose the bugs. And nice about clock gating verification is you have 2 designs, one with clock gating, one without clock gating. So you can do sequential equivalent checking. On the VC formal, ICQ is a perfect tool for this target. We have our circuitry set up, and then we have a chicken bit. We can disable, enable the chicken bit, and can we prove the equivalency. So with the advance of a formal equivalence checking tool, we can achieve self-quality. In the past, we can have like a 10%, we start with a 10% of conversion. Now all the way we can have all the units foolproof by VC formal SEQ tool. That gave us a high confidence, and we can tape out chip without any clocking bug.
Yeah, thank you so much for sharing your experience there. I know, you know, at our end, we continuously improving VC formal performance and convergence. But I think part of your success is also related to the methodology you have and the concept that you talked about of design for verification, where you're helping designers to use certain clock gating circuitry in order to make formal successful. Can you highlight on some of the techniques that you guys used?
I started doing clock gating about 15 years ago. And at that time, we had to create our own test bench using formal product verification tool. And we found it's really hard. There's a lot of complication come from the design itself, because RTL designer, they have a lot of freedom on how to implement their clock gating. And that introduced a big verification challenge for the formal verification tool. And we realized if we can put a little bit of restriction on how RTL can be implemented, can implement their design, we can have much better design for formal verification. For example, recently we published our RTL coding guideline to the RTL team from our formal team. We asked our RTL designer follow certain rules, such as they need to use dedicated clock gating cell. They need to have their clock enable equation. Also, their reset be part of the port of the gating cell. And we want them to do hierarchical clock gating design. And for large design with complicated clock gating equation, we want them to build in their clock enable as part of their output port for that module. So a lot of the rule we enforce to them, and if they follow that rule, we can have a much simpler formal test bench. We can easily achieve convergence. But meanwhile, we also educate our RTL designer how formal to work. We teach them cone of inference, the sequential depth of the formal tool, so they understand, don't do complicated clock gating design, such as they extend the clock based equation by 100 cycles. So by avoid doing that, we always have a smaller problem for formal equivalence checking tool. Then we can have convergence.
Yeah, thank you for sharing those techniques. I really hope that the industry can learn from you guys and adopt a methodology that can lead to clock gating sign-off. Now, my last question is related to RISC-V core verification. We often get asked the question about how is RISC-V CPU verification different from that of other CPU architecture in terms of formal verification. Can you share some light from your perspective?
I've been working on formal verification for around 20 years. I have worked on CPU, GPU, and SoC project. I use all the major formal verification tools on the market. From all these years, when we start doing our formal verification, we'll always start with reading the specification, understand the design, talk to the RTL designer, then come up with a formal test plan, and then we'll execute the test plan, leverage our formal verification expertise. And for all this project, I can see this is a common principle. We follow them, we execute the same procedures. And for RISC-V, it's an open source essay, it's a license free, but how we execute formal verification still be the same. We still apply our formal verification for CPU pipeline, we still focus on memory subsystem, we still doing our C2RTL or data path for our floating point. So all these rules on the target formal verification still exist. And for me, the short answer is I see there are big similarity between the RISC-V or traditional CPU verification. Fundamental, in the end day, you still be the expert of your design. You still be the master of your formal verification skills.
Yeah, I definitely agree with you. The methodology doesn't change. Well, thank you so much, Shaun, for sharing with us your expertise here. And for our audience out there, if you want to know more about VC Formal and our sequential equipped checking app, please visit our website. Thank you so much and see you next time.